गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, यू डिड फर्स्ट बिट इन एक्सरसाइज 7.9। नाउ लेट अस डू सेकंड बिट। इन सेकंड बिट यू हैव टू स्केच द ग्राफ। ऑफ द फॉलोइंग फंक्शंस। फर्स्ट वन, y इज इक्वल टू -1/3 x क्यूब -3x प्लस 2। सो लेट अस डू दिस प्रॉब्लम फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, राइट? सो सॉल्यूशन, See, this function is cubic polynomial, right? Y equal to f of x, that is equal to -1/3 x cube -3x plus 2. So how many roots it exists? It exists 3 roots. So let me factorize it by using synthetic method, by substituting 1, it will be 0. So by synthetic method, I am choosing 1 here. X cube coefficient, x square coefficient 0, x coefficient -3 and 2. So I am taking x equal to 1, here 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, here 2, -2. So here it is 0. So one factor is of x minus 1, one factor, and remaining polynomial, this is x square coefficient, this is x coefficient constant. So x square plus x minus 2. Now split this quadratic polynomial also into factors. X square plus x minus 2 we can write as -1/3 x minus 1 x minus 1 into x plus 2. So these are the required factors of the function. Okay. So what we got? Y equal to f of x is equal to -1/3 x minus 1 into x minus 1, x minus 1 whole square plus x plus 2. So these are the factors of the polynomial, which is given y equal to f of x as -1/3 x cube -3x plus 2. Right? I found the factors. First point, what is the domain? Domain of the function is all real numbers. Why? Because it is a polynomial. All real numbers is the domain. Right? Now let me find the intercepts. If I put y equal to 0, then we get x minus 1 whole square x plus 2 is equal to 0. Here x equal to 1 comma minus 2. So x intercepts are one comma 0 minus 2 comma 0. So curve is intersecting positive x axis at 1, negative x axis at minus 2. Next, to get y intercepts, Put x equal to 0, we get y equal to directly, if this is 0, this is 0, so you will get minus 2 by 3. Therefore, y intercept is 0 comma minus 2 by 3. So it is intersecting, curve intersecting negative y axis at minus 2 by 3. Right? Now two points over. Now third point. For third point, we are going to find the critical points. To get the critical points, we have to differentiate the given function f dash of x. So by differentiating -1/3 outside, 3x square minus 3. By taking 3 common, so you will get 1 minus x square. By taking -3 common, you will get 1 minus x square. So by taking f dash of x is equal to 0, we will get the critical points. 1 minus x square equal to 0, x is equal to plus 1 minus 1 are critical points. Therefore, critical points occurs at x equal to 1 minus 1. Okay. Now, to find the local maximum, local minimum, we have to find the second derivative also. Here only I am finding second derivative. F double dash of x is what? Minus 2x. F double dash of x is minus 2x, right? Now I am checking the local maxima, local minima at the critical points, right? At x equal to 1, x point, fourth point, at x equal to 1, f double dash of 1. What is f double dash of x? We got minus 2x. So minus 2 into 1, which is less than 0. So therefore, function has local maximum. Local maximum at x equal to 1. Local maximum value? Local maximum value. What is local maximum value? F of 1. F of 1 is 1 here minus 3, so it is 0. 1 is a factor, no? So it is 0. So local maximum is f of 1 equal to 0. Local maximum is occurring at, right? Occurring at 1. Now, at x equal to minus 1. At x equal to minus 1. At x equal to minus 1. F of minus 1 is minus 1. It becomes plus 2, which is greater than 0. So, function has local minimum. Local minimum. At x equal to minus 1. To get local minimum, put minus 1. In function. So here minus 1, or you can substitute in this, or you can substitute here also. Minus 1, minus 1, minus 2, minus 2 whole square, 4. 4 here, minus 1 plus 1, 4, 4 by 3, minus 4 by 3. Minus 4 by 3 is the local minimum value. Okay. Right. After that, concavity. Concavity of the function, right? It is depending on second derivative. So we have second derivative is x point, fifth point, concavity. F double dash of x is what? Minus 2x. So here check, if x is negative, then it will be positive. So it is positive for all x greater than 0. Sorry, less than 0. For negative and negative real axis, f double dash of x is positive. Therefore, function has concavity up for negative values of x. That means on negative real line, the function graph will be concavity up, right? Next time the f double dash of x is minus 2x, which is less than 0 for all x greater than 0. Therefore, function has concavity down for all positive values of x. For all positive values of x, concavity is down. Now point of inflection means if you get f double dash of x equal to 0 is minus 2x. So at x equal to 0, f double dash of x will be 0. At x equal to 0, only f double dash of x equal to 0. Therefore, 0 comma f of 0. 0 comma f of 0 is nothing but 0 comma minus 2 by 3 is the point of inflection. Point of inflection. And last part is asymptotes. Check the function. If you put minus x, you cannot get the same function. By putting minus y, you cannot get the same function. By putting minus y minus x, you cannot get the same function. Therefore, there is no asymptotes. There are no asymptotes. There are no asymptotes for the function. Asymptotes for the function. For the given function. For the given function, there are no asymptotes. Now let me draw the figure. So before that, we have to write the critical points. Critical points are x equal to plus 1 minus 1 and local minima attaining at minus 1 at x equal to minus 1 local minima. Local minima. Local minima occurring at x equal to minus 1. At x equal to plus 1, local maxima. Local maxima. X intercepts are minus 2, plus 1. Y intercepts are minus 2 by 2. Right? If x less than 0, concave up. If x is greater than 0, concave down. So these points enough to draw the graph. So it is crossing x-axis at minus 2, this is minus 2, this is minus 1, this is minus 3, this is 1 and this is 2. This crossing minus 2 and plus 1 x-axis, and it is intersecting y-axis at minus 2 by 3. Minus 2, minus 3, so on. So it is crossing minus 2 by 3 means it is nothing but 0 point something. 0.6 something here. It will be crossing like this. And when it is at left hand side, concavity up. So left hand side, at left x axis, x values are less than concave up. When you are drawing at left hand side, the graph will be goes up like this, and it is crossing x axis at minus 2. Okay, and at right hand side, when x axis it is x values are positive and concavity down, so we have to down right down when it crosses the it touches the x axis at 1. Why? Because in x intercept is 1. So first of all, go to 1 like this, in this manner. Concavity, show concavity is down and it is touching x-axis at 1 and goes like this. So this is the required graph. Always show the concavity down here at right hand side of y-axis. Why? Because for all positive values, concavity down, for negative values, concavity up, and it is crossing x-axis at minus 2 plus 1 and y-axis at minus 2 by 3. This is y-intercept. Minus 2 by 0.6 something. Okay, 0.6. Not at minus 1. This is minus 1. Like this, you have to draw the sketch graph. Rough sketch. Okay. Next problem. Second problem. Draw the rough sketch of y equal to x into root of 4 minus x. So solution, given y equal to f of x, which is equal to x into root of 4 minus x, right? So see the function, it is under root function, it is defined fine, only under root function is greater than 0. So it is defined, that means it is defined for 4 minus x greater than or equal to 0. So, by taking x minus 4 less than or equal to 0, x less than or equal to 4. So, what is the domain? Therefore, domain is minus infinity to 4. This is the domain of the function, right? Thereafter, intercepts. Second point, intercepts. suppose I am taking y equal to 0. Put y equal to 0. Put y equal to 0. What we will get? What you will get? X into 4 minus x whole to the power of 1 by 2 is equal to 0. Either x equal to 0 or 4 minus x whole to the power of 1 by 2 is equal to 0. 4 minus x is equal to 0, x is equal to 4. So curve is passing through by putting x equal to 0, we get y equal to 0. So it is passing through, the curve is passing through the origin and intersecting x axis at 4. Therefore, we can conclude that it is passing through the origin and intersecting x axis at 4. It is passing through the origin. So here you can write clearly. Clearly it is passing through. Clearly it is passing through. Passing through the origin. Through the origin. And intersecting x-axis at 4. It is intersecting x-axis at 4. Okay. Now to get the critical points, we have to differentiate it. So y equal to f of x is equal to x into root of 4 minus x. Now first differentiation, f dash of x, u into v method. First u derivative 1, root of 4 minus x plus leaving u 4 minus x derivative 1 by 2 derivative 1 by 2 4 minus x whole to the power of 1 by 2 minus 1 x derivative minus 1. So you will get 4 minus x minus x by 2 root of 4 minus x. Okay. Alright. By taking LCM, 2 into 4 minus x by 2 into root of 4 minus x. 8 minus 2x minus x minus 3x by 2 into root of 4 minus x. So this is the first derivative. Okay, now to get the critical points, I will take f dash of x is equal to 0. So from that you will get 8 minus 3x by square root of 2 into square root of 4 minus x is equal to 0. From this you will get 8 minus 3x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 8 by 3. X equal to 8 by 3 is the critical point. Right. After critical point we have to check the local maxima, local minima. Right? For the function. For that we have to differentiate f dash of x again. So what we have, f dash of x is 8 minus 3x by 2 into root of 4 minus x. Second derivative, let me find. So here we, after getting 8 by 3, write down critical point occurs at. Critical point occurs at x equal to 8 by 3. Now f double dash of x. First v square, or you can take 1 by 2 common. V square means 4 minus x, root 4 minus x whole square. U derivative, minus 3, leave the denominator, minus, leave the numerator, 8 minus 3x, denominator derivative, 8 minus 3x derivative. 8 minus 3x derivative is minus 1 by 2 root of 4 minus x. Minus 1 by 2 root of 4 minus x is v derivative. Now by simplifying this, 1 by 2 denominator 4 minus x, here by taking the LCM, minus 6 4 minus x minus 6 4 minus x, minus 2 minus plus 8 minus 3x by 2 root 4 minus x. So 2 root 4 minus x. By simplifying it, one by two minus 24 plus 6x plus 8 minus 3x by 2 into 4 minus x whole to power of 3 by 2.
Whole to power of 3 by 2.
So here by multiplying this you will get 6x minus 3x is 3x, 24 minus 8 minus 16, 3x minus 16 by 4 into 4 minus x whole to power of 3 by 2. This is second derivative. Now let me check the second derivative at critical point, f double dash of 8 by 3. So 8 minus 16 after substituting 8 by 3 here. 3, 3 cancel by 4 into 4 minus 8 by 3 whole to power of 3 by 2. 8 minus 16 is minus 8 by 4. By 12 minus 8, 12 minus 8, 4, 4 by 3 whole to power of 3 by 2. So which is negative? Which is negative sign? Negative sign. So if it is negative sign, f double dash of is negative at the critical point. So if it is negative, we can say that it has local maximum. Local maximum. So we can say that therefore function has local maximum. Therefore function has local maximum. Maximum at x equal to 8 by 3. Local maximum value. How to get local maximum? Maximum. F of 8 by 3. So in the function I am substituting 8 by 3. Root of 4 minus 8 by 3. 8 by 3. 12, 12 minus 8. 4, 4 by 3. You can write 2 8 is 16 by 3 root 3. 16 by 3 root 3 is the local maximum. And local minimum is 0. Let me substitute C here. Concavity of the function. We have the derivative f double dash of x is equal to 3x minus 16 by 4 into 4 minus x whole to the power of 3 by 2. See this function. If numerator negative, automatically total will be negative, right? And this should be positive when x is less than 4, right? It will be defined when x is less than 4. If x less than 4, for x less than 4, here you will get the numerator negative, this is positive. So totally if x is less than 4, then this will be less than 0 for all x less than 4. So if it is less than 4, then x values are less than 4, then concavity of function is function concavity. Concavity doubt. For x less than 4. Concavity down for x less than 4. Now let me draw the figure for this. So what we have? Function passing through origin. We got passing through origin. X intercept 4. And concavity, local maxima. local maxima at x equal to 8 by 3. X equal to 8 by 3, it is local maximum. And concave down for x less than 4. And function define in only minus infinity to 4. At 4 what? At 4 it is touching x-axis, means function value is 0. So suppose I am taking here 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay. I am taking 1, 2, 3, 4 here. So it is touching x-axis at 4 and left hand side of 4, concavity down, and at 8 by 3 it is occurring maximum value. 8 by 3 means it is nearly 2.6 here, nearly here. This is 8 by 3, assume this as 8 by 3. Here it is attaining maximum, local maximum. So we can draw like this. It is passing through the origin and concavity down, right? So at 8 by 3 it is attaining maximum value and concavity down, passing through origin like this. This is the required graph. So according to this only I drawn the rough sketch of the curve. Defining, if the given function is defined, you can draw the function only at left hand side of 4. Here, closed interval 4, and it is passing through 0, 0, intersection 4, it is touching x-axis at 4 and passing through origin. So here we can draw like this or like this, but concavity is down at left hand side of 4, so I am taking like this, and it is attaining maximum value at 8 by 3, 8 by 3 means 2.6 something. So here I am taking maximum value. So from this point you have to draw the curve down, and it is passing through the x-axis. Okay, in this way you can solve the remaining problems also.